Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm excited because the kids are heading back to school. It's back to school time. A great time for us all. I thought we would spend a little bit of time today looking at three very cool apps that I've found for back to school. Two of them work for both high school and university level students, and one of them is just for the teachers out there. Actually, it's for the teachers and students, but teachers are going to like it more than anybody else, I think. Curious? It's back to school today on Dotto Tech. There are a variety of great apps out there that are available to help kids out in school. And since more kids are taking smartphones to school, and certainly at the university level, I would be surprised to find any student in a class without a smartphone. There's a few tools that I thought we would take a look at to help in that space. Let's begin by taking a look at a tool that I found on Android. Now, this is my Samsung Galaxy phone here. A tool which is called Studious. Studious is a free app available both Android and iOS that is a calendaring app that does a variety of different things on the smartphone that really help out. First of all, you put in your entire schedule, all of your classes you put in. When you put a new class into a schedule, into the schedule, they do ask you the class name, the start and finish time, etc. Allow you to give it an icon. But here is something that's a little bit of magic. Do you know how every time you go into class, you got to remember to put your phone on airplane mode or silent mode so you're not going to ring in the middle of the class, disturb the class, and get the gain the ire of the instructor of the class. This automatically sets your phone into those preferences in your phone for that schedule. So it'll put it to vibrate, it'll put it into airplane mode, it'll turn off the speaker, it'll do all those sorts of things right for every time you take that course. So you set the course in and you set your phone up. That's kind of brilliant, isn't it? On a more practical basis, well, I mean, that is fairly practical, but as far as helping you out with school, this helps you not get in trouble at school, which is a good thing, but to actually help you get the work done, when you're actually in any one of the courses and you bring it up, that's a good thing. Watch The Princess Bride. It has modules for following your homework and tests, but here you can add different assignments that you can do, that you can set due dates on and create reminders for. So as your instructor is giving you assignments to complete, you can be putting them in and creating a task list out of this all within Studious. Free, available in both Mac and iOS. Let's just take a look here. We've got there's the iOS version. Oh, the iOS version is 99 cents. Let's take a look at the Android version. Do I have it on the Android as well? Studious Android, there it is. The Android version is... where is the price? It's already installed. I think the Android version might be free. At any rate, have a look. Studious is an awesome tool. The next app is more university level, and that is an app called EasyBib. Now, I've got it installed on my iPhone here. And what it does is it helps you doing all of your different citations as you're doing research. So if you're in the library and you're doing some reading on a book, and you have to write down all of the different citations for anything that you're reading. What this allows you to do is to use the camera app on your smartphone in order to capture the citation. And all you do is go to the bookmarks. So all I'm going to do is go to the barcode. When I go add citation, this book here, let's take a look. I'll show you the book. The book is The Digital Dollar by my buddy Joe Wozni. Let's see if it's a good learning book. There we go. I didn't do anything. I just focused it on the barcode, and there it does. It comes up with the citation in MLA, APA format. Oh, I got to click on the phone. APA format or Chicago. And then you can take that. You can save the bookmarks here onto your phone, or you can email them to yourselves as well. Now, these folks actually have a full-on website called EasyBib, and there's a premium version of it available, but basically you can save all of your different notes and that sort of stuff right within the website, which integrates as well. The phone app, though, completely free, and I would say pretty darned useful. The next app I want to talk about is Remind. It used to be called Remind 101, and it is a privacy-enabling app that allows communication between teachers and students, especially at the high school and elementary school, and protecting the privacy of both parties. Here's the basis of it. texting would be a great way to remind students of assignments, to remind the kids in the band program to bring their instruments on a certain day, and the teachers would be happy to text that information to the parents or to the students, those reminders, but that exposes them to giving out their cell phone number, basically their mobile number, to all of the students in their class or all of the parents, which gives those people probably inappropriate access to the educator. So we want to protect the teacher's privacy. Remind sets up a buffer so that, let me just sign in and I'll show you. It allows teachers to send from a semi-anonymous account. Kids and parents sign up for the service. They text in a sign up. Here's the account here. It walks you through the whole process. But basically, you can add students and parents to your class. They can text to this number with this message in it, which will automatically enroll them into the class list, or they can use this QR code. And then the teacher can compose any texts that they want to send, and they send them, and it comes from an anonymous account. It doesn't come from the teacher's account. Parents and students can reply to that account, and the teachers will see it in the web interface. It's simple, it's elegant, again, it's free, and it really does dual purpose, protecting teachers' privacy while allowing them to use the best communication technology to be able to communicate with their students, enriching their lives. A win-win situation. All of these apps today are win-win situations. And you spending time with me today, I hope you found it to be a win-win situation. There's three ways that you can stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. If you haven't yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to this channel, and we send out new how-to videos on a regular basis, especially now that the school year and we're back into a regular routine. There'll be multiple videos coming per week. Also, if you're interested in our webinars or our courses, sign up for our newsletter. I do a regular series of webinars. Just completed a really awesome one on using Evernote. You find out about those by signing up for the newsletter, and you just click on the link there to sign up for that. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. We're supported by our viewers, for the most part, through a crowdfunding site called Patreon. If you want to know more about it, please click on the link there for Patreon. Until next time, have fun storming a castle.